If you're not happy with the way that your YouTube streams are looking when you're going live using OBS Studio and you're streaming in 1080p, 60 frames per second, I'm gonna show you the best settings you're gonna be able to utilize so you don't have no lag and that your image looks crisp. So the first thing you're gonna do is inside of OBS Studio, you're gonna come to where it says settings. Now I'm gonna show you a version of the steps here on a Mac and on a Windows. It'll be seamless based on the machine that you're utilizing here. So the first thing you want to make sure that you do is that when you come to stream is that you connect your account to YouTube and use the recommended settings that are there. Then where it says here, ignore streaming settings service recommendations, you want to make sure that that is checked. The next thing you're going to want to do is for the output. This is where everything is going to matter when it comes to whether your stream is going to lag or not. Of course, the machine that you're utilizing plays a big role into it as well, whether or not it can support streaming. Now, if you've utilized these settings that I'm going to show you here today, and you're still experiencing some issues, it could be more of a hardware, meaning your computer cannot support to be able to stream, and you may want to be able to utilize a web-based streaming platform. And if that's you, go ahead and leave a comment below and I'll recommend some recommendations for platforms you can utilize if you have a low-end computer. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do here on output mode is you wanna select advanced. This is gonna be the same for Windows and the same here for Mac. So here on the left-hand side, you're gonna see the Mac settings. So if you're on Mac, your audio encoder is gonna be Core Audio ACC. Then for your video encoder, super important, you select Apple VT H.264 hardware encoder. And then for your CBR, you're gonna wanna select rate control CBR. And then for your bit rate, you can have this at about 9,000 would be a good sweet spot here. And then for your keyframe intervals, you wanna have it at 2. Profile high, and you want to use B frames. And we'll get back to your second of how you determine what bit rate you can support, because you may be putting in the right bit rate, but your internet may not be able to support that, which is going to cause some lag or some kind of not making your quality look good when somebody's watching it. So I'll talk about how to be able to test it here in a moment. Now for Windows, what you want to be able to do is you want to go ahead and follow these settings here. So your audio encoder is going to be FFmpegAAC. Then you want to use NVIDIA, or this may say AMD based on what graphics cards you're utilizing, but this is the one you want to select, NVIC H.264. Rate control, you want to have it as CBR. And then again, the bit rate, you want to have this at about 9,000. Your keyframe intervals would be at 2. Preset, be P6 slower, better quality. Tuning, high quality. Multipass mode, 2 passes. Profile high, you want to have look ahead on. Cycle visual tuning on. GPU 0, and max B frames 2. Now you may not see all of these settings, and that's fine. Just fill in the things that you do see on your end. And then you wanna select apply. And now we wanna make sure that we test our internet speed to make sure we have this set up correctly. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna go to speedtest.net, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. You're gonna hit the big green button that says go. This is gonna then go ahead and give you your download and your upload speed. What matters for live streaming is gonna be your upload speed. So in order for you to have a 9,000 bit rate, I always say that wants to be about 50% of your upload. So for me, if I wanted to use 9, this would have to be at least 18. Now for me, it's 938. So I have way more than enough than I need. But if you have about a 20 upload, you would be able to use 9,000 as your bit rate for YouTube streaming in 1080p, 60 frames per second without any kind of lags. And of course, the more that you have, the better. The more room you have if you're using other things, other devices on your internet, it won't interfere with your live streaming. So once you've determined that you have enough upload, you can now come back here to OBS and then you can go ahead and hit start streaming, and that's gonna send your stream over to YouTube, and you should have a clearer, more smoother stream utilizing these settings. Now, if you want to know how to add overlays and graphics to make your stream look more professional, go ahead and watch this video right here where I walk you step-by-step inside of OBS Studio, how to add overlays, alerts, and everything to make your stream more exciting. Click that video right there. I'll see you in the next video.